broken the ancient commandments and crafted a bond with one of the light. Our laws are clear. They demand you be eternally imprisoned. As for the impure child, she must be kept from the path of the dark arts forever.
Hey guys, Raijin Vex is here, and today I will be playing Bayonetta, and it's probably my favorite game ever made, period. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. I love this game, don't go to demo. Bayonetta. But in celebration of Bayonetta 2 that's coming out later in October, I decided I'm going to do this game for you guys and show off the original game that came out for the Xbox. And when the Wii U version comes out, well, that comes with Bayonetta 2, I'll show off all the neat extra things that they added, even though I don't really know, you know, what all they added yet, other than the costumes. But, let's just get to a new game here. I'm going to play and start a new game. And yes, I know I will not be able to save from a checkpoint. And I was gonna do this on the hardest difficulty, but like, it's just too, it would take too long, and I wouldn't want to show off the game for those who never played it before. And for those of you who are, you know, new to hack and slashers, you can always play this easy mode on automatic, automatically locks on to everything, and very easy, which just makes, there's no point in very easy. You're just scared if you play on that difficulty, but we're gonna go on normal. Sorry, I have allergies lately, and pollen in the air is making my nose act really strange, so if I sniffle a little bit, it's okay. Just, you'll get used to it. Let's just go normal. Woo! Oh man, not even 5 seconds in and we're already in some shit.
Long since erased from the records of time, there once existed two European clans who served as overseers of history for the powers that be. The Umbra Witches, dwellers of the darkness, and the Lumen Sages, controllers of the light. The clans paid each other great respect, and their efforts to maintain the balance between them defended the just passage of time. Yet one day, that balance was toppled.
By the way, this scene doesn't have a health bar. You can't die no matter what you do, so just have at it. Have fun. Take a look at the spectacle. That is this game.
The once harmonious clans fell into disagreement.
Hi, Angel,
and
Dragon
stoked
thing.
The flames of hatred against each other, resulting in an era of strife. The conflict between the Umbra and the Lumen threw all of Europe into a chaotic loop of battle, ambush, assassination, and casualty. It was truly a gruesome war. Despite the tremendous radiance of God shining upon them, the Lumen Sages were gradually weakened by the assault of the secretive Dark Witches. Years after the balance was lost, the war had ended in the Umber Witches' favor.
Yeah, this guy likes to narrate a lot, but I'll get my chance to talk eventually, because I have a lot to say about this game. Narrator? You gonna say anything else? No? Okay. Oh, hi there, big dragon thing. You gonna come down and have a taste of Bayonetta? I think he does. Oh god, he's throwing fireballs at me.
Was short-lived. Fearing the witch's dark abilities, humans began to condemn the remaining Umbra. They launched the witch hunts, rounding up the battle-weary witches with little resistance, and subjugating those who wished to continue the struggle. Human faith in the miracles of their god pushed the witch hunts further, and soon the Umbra witches, keepers of the darkness, were extinguished from the earth. All but one.
Oh no! Interesting cutscene. Back to loading screen. If you're wondering why I can move this in the loading screen, you'll see why eventually. Anyways, plot. And here we are, the prologue, the vestibule, something in whatever language. I forget where this game takes place in England, so something in Britain. I don't know. I'm not that culturally sound. That's not the right word. But whatever, let's start. Any day now, loading screen. Witness one of my favorite video game cutscenes ever made. I love you, Platinum. Thank you for making this game. Yuji, you a bro, though. You a bro for life. You too, Yusuke. And Hideki Kamiya, the godfather of hack and slashes. Oh, way to piss on a director, fag. Favorite game creator.
Even Oleg the Destroyer gets scrambled in the end, right? You know, I still don't get why the hell you dragged me out here for these things. I just drop off the merchandise. Hey. Bet you can't guess what today is. Reading the good Lord's book ain't gonna do much. People been waiting for this asshole to get whacked for ages. Please. Hell, look around. There's no love lost for old Humpty Dumpty. But you gotta keep the outfit happy. We don't take care of him, they take care of us. And I prefer my shoes made out of rubber, not concrete. But hey, it's that kind of town. Without good-hearted souls like us to put these bastards 6 feet under, where'd society be? Of course, the pay's not bad either. Jesus, you really get into this shit, don't you? If it were me, I'd be praying he ends up barbecue. Or at least sunny side up. You can keep praying, but the only way this guy's meeting the Lord is if God's hungry for breakfast. Speaking of hungry, we done here? My kids are baking me a birthday cake tonight. Cute little fuckers, I tell you what. Well then, adios.
Way to throw a cigar, bro.
What the fuck? They're here? For this douchebag?
God told you wrong, life. Asshole.
I can't see a thing. Oh, but they're there, ain't they? You hearing me? You can see them, can't you?
I see them. They are instruments of God, descending upon his heavenly rays to earth.
Oh my God!
Dear Lord, grant us guidance, and keep safe the souls of our loved ones for all eternity.
For those of you who are religious in any way, I advise you y'all click off this video now. I'm just saying, cause shit's about to get real.
Next time you want me hands on you, you better make sure I'm dead. Now move out the way. Go, go, go!
Go, 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 Dad!
If it ain't my good buddy Denzel, how about you get out of here? You die, and I'm gonna have to go back in that hole chasing after the money you want.
Do you naughty little angels deserve a good spanking?
Beautiful. Prepare to hear this song a lot, by the way. But I love it.
Bayonetta.
quality. I've got quantity.
Those are lollipops.
If you're just gonna watch, I'm putting you to the work. That was your last call. No more shots from me, Bayonetta.
Alright, guys, meet Bayonetta, an angel killer, and tutorial interrupts me. Thanks, I know how to play it. Punch, get move. Yes. Kick, yes, I know how to kick. I really should have skipped the tutorials, but I gotta show it off. Now they're getting into the main mechanic with this. Anyways, the dodging. Yeah, switch time. This is this game's main mechanic. If you dodge right at the last possible moment, you will activate it, and this time around, you will slow down for everyone else, but you'll still move at the same speed. I'm failing because I'm trying to talk. Life, for example. Okay, sure. Like that. Half the time when you activate Witch Time, it's gonna be by accident. You're just gonna be in the middle of dodging enemies, and you're just gonna be like, oh, I activated Witch Time. Well, shit. That's basically how it goes. As back to what I was saying, Bayonetta is an angel killer. And most games like to go with a cliche route and just be like, hey, I'm killing demons, because demons are bad, but this game likes to put a little twist on it. We're killing angels from heaven, God's little helpers. And for angels, they sure look demonic looking. And I love this game's sense of humor and just originality. This game is really just fun to play. If you think about it, it's just... the animations are smooth. The combat is fun and addicting. It's just... you want to pick it up and play it. To get more into the combat aspect of it, I just, it's more of a Devil May Cry sort of game. Like, you're not gonna... the director of this game was Deku. He also directed games such as Devil May Cry, the original ones anyway, before he moved on to Platinum, and he made games like Bayonetta and Metal Gear Rising. Yeah. And if I stop talking, that's because I am really into this game. I love playing it. Sometimes that will happen. Just forewarning. And here's our second set of angels. If they will properly introduce them, I don't think they will. And here's the next tutorial. And hold on. Here's one of my favorite moves that Bayonetta can do by rotating the analog stick and pressing whatever button she has her guns on, whether it be hands or feet. You will do this. You rotate and just shoot however you want. And I love this. They obviously put a lot of time and effort into making the combat work well with this character. She can even do it with her feet. How about that shit? We apply that to combat. It's just as effective. But don't like expect it to work on every enemy. It's only the little ones that they really work on. I guess another thing I should probably mention before I get on with this playthrough, I have a new microphone, if you can't tell already by my voice sounding different, if it sounds any different from my last microphone. We recently bought a Blue Snowball. It's a nice little microphone for like $50 on Amazon. And it sounds really nice, you know, it's easy to set up, everything, you just plug it in and it just works. So I just decided to like upgrade everything so my videos would be more entertaining to watch and not just standard definition, because I feel bad for making SD videos. I think someone's taken someone to heaven. I don't think it's that guy though.
Haven't you figured it out yet? There's no quarter for you in this world.
But yeah, the whole thing with Bayonetta and the angels. Why is she fighting them? You may ask? Well, you'll find out later in the game, but they really don't explain it that well. She's killing them, really. I mean, they're supposed to be this world's saviors or everything, but they don't really explain it that much. And I'll get into more detail on that later when the story actually starts to develop. Nice styling finish, and I have a silver. Sometimes those games can be cruel with ratings.
Radon should be paying me for even touching these toys.
You have any idea how much this is gonna cost to fix? How the fuck do I always get wrapped up in this shit?
That's your fault, buddy. That is your fault.
Engine still purrs nicely. Now, About this little thing you've been looking into for me, Enzo. Let's have a quick chat.
See? This is why I told you I was going home. I just got held up in the air by some invisible things, and you want an intelligence briefing? It never stops with you!
You keep bellyaching like that, and you're liable to wake Eggman from the dead.
I never understood. Are they referencing Sonic the Hedgehog? Because they keep mentioning Eggman, and I'm just like, this game was published by Sega. So I'm just like, are they referencing Dr. Eggman or some bullshit? I don't know.
Wait, Rodan. What about Eggman?
Such a popular chap. I bet they hate him down there as much as you did when he was up here. We just need to make sure he won't come crawling back when they kick him out.
Nothing a flower bed can't fix. Fill her up.
You heard the man. Finish up in 5 minutes or you're walking home to your cake and candles.
What? Don't you leave me here!
And there we are. You can actually practice your combos while the game is loading, which is really nice, actually. Sucks to be you, Enzo, or Enzo. I almost said your name wrong.
If I could see them bastards that did this to my car, forget about it.
Enzo, the road. Pay attention.
How can you be so calm? You're still getting screwed in all this too. Of all the low-life scum in too deep in this town, I've never seen one get wrapped up in a fight with God's messengers. Dressed like a nun, too! When you end up in the afterlife, that's not going to be pretty.
Ha, implying Bayonetta 2.
The little outfits. The toys are nice.
20 years ago, you woke up stuck in a casket at the bottom of a lake. All you can remember is that you're a witch. But now, you're stuck. Because you gotta sacrifice our halo-wearing friends every day, or they'll drag your ass back down to hell. I know, I thought I got screwed, but being forced to slap around the divine for a living? That's really getting screwed.
If I needed a biographer, you wouldn't be my first choice. I see to the funeral. You get me the information I asked for. That was our deal.
Come on now! Look at my poor car! I'm working for free after this! At least let me get a drink at Rodan's before you start grilling me. The info I got is good. It's gonna get you close to finding the other stone in the pair and figuring out some of that lost past of yours. I swear. Jewels instead of cash, just like a girl. Jesus, can't you take a joke?
Enzo, someone's given you a present. Too bad. I can't stand bugs.
Coming plane. Hello, Mystery Witch.
Hmm. to Bayonetta. All that sleeping made you soft.
Start talking. You have a time limit with this section. You need to kill each angel or three angels with a torture attack. This serves as a tutorial, I guess. You see those little shining things beneath the health bar. Once those fill up all the way, you can execute a torture attack, and those vary from rising guillotines out of the ground to hanging angels in the air to summoning a giant iron maiden from the ground and kicking them inside while spanking them with your boot. Yeah, this game's crazy. If you haven't noticed. But this mission shouldn't give you any trouble anyway, as long as you fill out the gauge. By the way, if you get hit, the gauge will actually go down. And here's the Iron Maiden. Oh, no, that's a tombstone, actually. Hey, this time I got a gold. And his hat just magically comes back on. Lucky you, Enzo. Lucky, lucky you.
Those assholes sure know how to get attention. Even perk the ears of the hotheads down home.
You don't say.
It's getting harder and harder to tell the worlds apart. Human world. Inferno. Paradiso. Who can tell the difference?
I can. Because there are angels, demons, and humans. I'm pretty sure anyone can.
Fight long enough in there and you'll really lose sight. Why the sudden interest in metaphysics?
It's a balance, right? Even if some of them like messing around with the humans. We've all got a stake in the status quo. But people keep fucking around like this, the Book of Revelations is gonna look like Mother Goose. Heaven and hell are gonna go straight for each other's throats.
Heaven and hell can tear each other to pieces for all I care. I've got my own problems to worry about.
Something's up. Everything was a bit too bracing. And Enzo's tip makes the timing too perfect. This reeks of a setup. Someone in one of those lost memories calling you out.
Ooh, doing some dirty stuff in the back of the bar? Rodan, I see what you're doing there.
These babies are special. built from an alloy the devil himself would kill to get his hands on. Don't break these, because they're one of a kind.
She breaks them in the movie. Oh, I love this game. Just being unnecessarily epic for no reason. And I love it that way.
Calling me out. I don't go in for strange offers. Then again, I'm getting a little tired of these weaklings they keep throwing at me. Maybe I should aim for something a bit more high class.
Pounding them down tonight, baby. Not to butt into your affairs, but I'm pretty sure you got somewhere better to be. The guys you're up against aren't the type to wait for you to finish a round.
Well, she fucked off really fast. Ayo.
Enzo. Her drinks are going on your tab, buddy. You deadbeat motherfucker.
And that's the end of the prologue. I'm pretty sure we got like a silver. No, we got a gold. And this is a little mini game section. You just gotta aim and shoot at the angels. You get a high score, you get to buy some items you can use in the game. And pertaining to items like stuff that will permanently increase your health, or items that will just like temporarily boost your health. Things like that. And I'm pretty sure I only have enough to buy a candy. Oh yeah, I can't buy any of this shit. I forgot. Oh well. Oh wait, no, I can exchange. What am I talking about? It's been a while since I played this game. Alright. Well, we have our next destination. So next time we meet, we're going to head to Angel's Metropolis and fight some more angels and see what's going on over there. So we'll see you guys next time.